Evening, students. Yesterday we have studied about phylum Coelenterata. What is the meaning of this Coelenterata? Coelenterates meaning what? Coelenterata meaning the organ. Coelenterata are also called as what? Tenopause. Coelenterata are also called as what? Cnidarians. Because they contain a specialized cell called cnidoblast cells. And how that cnidoblast cell was helping to this, that also we were studying. That is, what is the function of cnidoblast cell in the phylum, in this Coelenterata phylum? In Coelenterate, these cnidoblast cells were helping them for defense. What is the meaning of defense? When enemy comes to attack these organisms, when enemy come to attack this organism, at that time here they used tentacles or those stinging cells. The stinging cells they used to pierce those stinging cells or tube thread in the body of enemy, so that enemy will get paralyzed, and so that it can be get defense from the organism. So first function of that cnidoblast cell was defense. Another was to gather food. When organism Coelenterate want to eat food or consume food, they take use of the cnidoblast cells, and that cnidoblast cell, when animals are around this Coelenterata animal, it used to purge or sting that organism's body with the help of this tube thread. That's why that organism will get what? Paralyzed. And once that organism died, that Coelenterate can easily consume that organisms. First function of that cnidoblast cell was defense. Second function of that cnidoblast is to gather food. Third is anchorage. Third function of the cnidoblast cell was anchorage. Anchorage meaning support. With the help of those cnidoblast cells, the thread-like structure and cnidoblast cell, they used to get the support also. So these are the three functions we have learned about the cnidoblast cells. And cnidoblast cells is the unique feature of this Coelenterata phylum. After that we have studied the examples. Examples. We have studied examples. Along with that, we have studied the examples of Coelenterate. In that, we have studied about scientific name and common name of that organism. Why this Physalia is called as Portuguese man of war? Because this Portuguese man of war, why we call it as like this? Suppose this is the body of that Coelenterate with the tentacles and all. And you know, in those cells have cnidoblast cells also, and those cnidoblast cells have refractile rods also. And along with that, they have thread, their body. And whenever someone goes near these organisms, if this feel unprotected, immediately it will throw all these rods toward that person who is opposite to this organism. So these rods will damage that person. That's why they are called as what? Portuguese man of war. How these rods they are throwing on the opponent animals. Like in the war, how we throw arrows like that, they will throw these refractile rods on that body of opposite organism. So they are called as Portuguese man of war. scientific name along with the common names you have to learn. Yesterday we have studied the examples of this phylum also. We know Obelia. Obelia was showing what? Alternation of generation. What is the meaning of alternation of generation? One form of these animal will show sexual reproduction and another form will show what? Another form of the animal will show asexual. Within the same organism, this is the asexual form, which is called as polyp. Polyp meaning what? It is attached and not non-motile. This will produce bud asexually. Only one parent will produce this type of bud. And this bud has what? Both male and female gamete. And these buds, when it detach, it will grow as individual bud and male and female. So see, this is the medusa form, which is free living. Again, this free living form, that is medusa, will produce what? Gametes, and these gametes will fuse and then it will form what? Again, polyp stage. Medusa will form polyp sexually, and this polyp will form medusa form or moving form asexually. So this metagenesis also we have studied yesterday. So polyp is asexual form and medusa is sexual form. After that we have studied those example also. Now today which phylum we are going to study? Today we are going to study Ctenophora. This is the diagram they have shown in your NCERT book. And what is the name of this organism? Pleurobrachia. This Pleurobrachia is also called as what? Sea gooseberries. So about this we are going to study in today's class. So next, let's start with the today's class. It is the third phylum by the name Ctenophora. Before it was considered under coelenterates only, but after further study of this phylum, they show these animals which belong to this Ctenophora phylum, they shown certain variations. As compared to coelenterata, they were showing different characters. Few characters were differing from coelenterata. That's why again this phylum is separated from coelenterata. And this is also called as minor phylum. Minor why? Because this phylum contains very less number of organisms in this. That's why it is also considered as what? Minor phylum. Now what is the common name? The organisms which are coming under this are also called as what? Sea walnuts, or it is also called as what? Sea gooseberries or comb jellies. They are also called as what? Comb jellies. They are well known for their beauty and delicate nature. They are delicate organisms. Their delicate nature, and they are well known for their beauty and delicate nature. And when sun rays fall on the few members of this phylum, they will shine. That's why they are called as what? Bioluminescence emitting organisms also. Now, this is the common name of the organism which are coming under the phylum Ctenophora. Now, first you have to study about its habitat. What is the meaning of habitat? Where that organism lives. Habitat. this organism is exclusively marine. What is the meaning of exclusively marine? You know, in poriferans, Spongilla was freshwater organism. That Spongilla was found in freshwater. After that, you have studied Coelenterata. In Coelenterata, Hydra is also an example which was coming under freshwater aquatic habitat. But here, when you compare this Ctenophora with all those two phylums, these phylum contains only the organism which are found in marine habitat. Meaning, all the organisms which belong to this phylum are living in salty water or marine water. That's why they are called as what? Exclusively. After that, they may live in colony. Some are living solitary also. After habitat, level of organization. Which is the level of organization present in this organism? Level of organization. As you know, in porifera, there was cellular level of organization. Here, in Coelenterata, you have studied that is tissue level of organization. And even in Ctenophora, they show tissue grade of organization, or you can call it as tissue level of tissue level of organization. And in coelenterates, I told it is a group of tissue, and this group of tissue is doing same function and originated from the same cell. And here, to control this, there is development of nerve cell, and that neurons developed first time in the phylum Coelenterata, and those neurons were in the form of nerve net. Diffused type of neurons are present, nerves are present in this phylum Coelenterata, that you have to remember. Meaning nervous system, first time neurons or nerve cell like structure or nerve net, or you can call it as diffused nerve, developed in the phylum Coelenterata. And they don't have an aggregation of neurons in one place. If all the neurons are aggregated in one place, then it will called as cephalic structure or head like structure will be formed. Like humans, in humans, how those all the neurons are aggregated in our brain region, but like that in the Coelenterata, that type of nerve association is not seen. They are just found in diffused form. So here, which level of organization is seen? Tissue level of organization is present in the phylum Ctenophora. After level of organization, here pattern of digestion incomplete. Circulatory system is not present. Incomplete digestive pattern is incomplete. In porifera, pattern of digestion, that is totally absent only. Only that cell used to take food from the water surface with the help of coenocyte cells. Here the digestive pattern is incomplete. After pattern of digestion, come to the symmetry. Which type of symmetry is present in this phylum Ctenophora? Symmetry. They show radial symmetry. They have mentioned in your book that they are showing which type of symmetry? Radial symmetry. But if you want to go for more specific, few members are also show what? Biradial symmetry. Suppose this is the organism. Here only one opening is present. And these are the, if you want to cut this organism like this, you can get equal pieces, or else you can cut this organism like this, which is passing from central axis, or from this. then only you will get two equal pieces by passing through two planes. After the symmetry, germ layers. How many germ layers are present in this ctenophora? Two germ layers, that is outer ectoderm and inner endoderm. That is, these organisms are diploblastic. Here also you will see mesenchyme in between, the mesoglia in between ectoderm and endoderm. How many germ layers are present? Two. After the germ layers, segment their body is unsegmented. After segment, which basis of level of classification you have studied? Unsegmented and notochord is absent. So these are called considered under non-chordates. They are non-chordates. Apart from that, what is the speciality of these organisms that we are going to study? I told these organisms are exclusively marine. That is the first feature. Second special feature of this ctenophore is they show bioluminescence. What is the meaning of bioluminescence? The light emitting bio means living. Luminescence meaning something which shines. The light emitting organisms. Light emitting organisms are called as bioluminescent animals, and the phenomenon whose eliminate the light, that is called as what? Bio light emitting organisms. The property of light emission is called as what? Bioluminescence. And the organism who emit this light, they are called as bioluminescent animals. The light emitting property, the light emitting property of the living organisms will be the light emitting property of living organisms. It is called as what? Bioluminescence. When living organisms show light emission, then that type of phenomenon is bioluminescence. After that bioluminescence, what is the another feature present here? They are showing only after bioluminescence property, next phenomenon is they are carnivorous. That's why, meaning they eat on another organisms only. And you know, in Hydra, you have that Hydra organisms of Coelenterata possesses what? Tentacles and nidoblast cells. We have studied in the phylum Coelenterata that they have a specialized cell called nidoblast cells, which is, we have studied the properties also. But here nidoblast cells are not present. Then how these organisms will feed? They have tentacles. They have only two tentacles. In phylum Ctenophora, you will study, there are only two tentacles found, and those two tentacles having a specialized cells called coloblast or lasso cells. Those cells are called as what? Coloblast cells. These coloblast cells are present in place of nidoblast cells. As in case of Coelenterata, we have studied nidoblast cells. Here, coloblast cells are present on the tentacles. Or coloblast cells are also called as what? Lasso cells. lysosomes, it will secrete a mucus like or sticky substance. From that sticky substance, here the food particle or microorganisms will get attached to the tentacles and they will feed on those organisms. And apart from that, what is the another feature? In Coelenterata, you have studied tentacles are so many, but here only two tentacles are present. Apart from that, they bear 8 ciliated rows. These rows are how many in number? 8. And what is the function? They bear 8 ciliated rows. They are called as what? Comb plates. Ciliated meaning these rows are surrounded by the cilia. And these cilias help these organisms to do locomotion. So these 8 ciliated rows are called as comb plates. And this tentacle also possesses some sort of cilia. And this tentacle contains which type of cell? Coloblast cells, which secrete a sticky substance. This sticky substance helps these organisms to catch the prey. To catch the prey, they need one sticky substance, and that sticky substance is released by the coloblast cell. So this is the organism given in your book. That is what? Pleurobrachia. And these 8 ciliated rows, they are called as what? Comb plates. And these comb plates help these organism to show locomotion. How digestion is occurring in these organisms? Digestion as in Coelenterata, how digestion was occurring both intracellular as well as extracellular. In this also digestion occurs both intracellular as well as extracellular. Digestion is occurring as both intracellular and extracellular. As I have explained yesterday that in the body of this organism, cavity is present. This cavity was gastrovascular cavity here. Why gastro? Because the cells which surround that cavity secrete enzyme. Suppose these are the cells which are lining that gastrovascular cavity. These will release or secrete enzyme outside. So that food will get partially digested and remaining half digestion of this organism occur inside the cell. So half digestion occurring in the cavity and half digestion occurring inside the cell. So digestion is with the extra as well as intracellular. That's why here also the digestion is present as both extra as well as intracellular digestion. How they respire here? Totally respiratory system, circulatory system and excretory system is absent. System is absent, but respiration occurs. Respiration, excretion occur by the diffusion process. As water is coming, they are in contact with water. From water, oxygen will get in the cell, and from the cell, carbon dioxide will get outside the body or outside the cell of this organism. Respiration, excretion will occur in the form of diffusion from the body surface. From their body surface only, gaseous exchange of from these cells will take place. Okay, this is general body surface. From this only, gaseous exchange will take place in these organisms. After respiration, excretory waste is what? Excretory material is again ammonia. As these are aquatic, they can release ammonia outside their body. And nervous system developed bit, not system, only neurons developed bit. And after that, is there any skeletal system? No. Here skeletal system is not present. So skeletal system is also absent in these organisms. After that, come to the reproduction. How reproduction occurs in these organisms? As you know, in poriferans, reproduction is of two types, sexual as well as asexual. In sponges or poriferans, you have studied asexual reproduction takes place by formation of bud or formation of external or internal buds or fragmentation. And in sexual reproduction, in sponges, production of gametes used to take place and their fertilization was internal. Next, in phylum Coelenterata, you have studied there also reproduction will take place both by asexual as well as sexual. Asexual reproduction in Coelenterata takes place with the help of bud formation, external buds. And sexual reproduction was taking place by the production of gametes. But here, the reproduction is not asexual. Here always reproduction will be sexual. Only sexual reproduction takes place in this phylum. Organism of which belong to this phylum. Sexual reproduction. Where that reproduction takes place, inside the body or outside the body, fertilization is external. Organisms, these parts, sexual reproduction is occurring, meaning are they unisexual or bisexual? These organisms are bisexual, or you can call it as what? Hermaphrodite. Hermaphrodite organism. Development. How development takes place in these organisms? Development is indirect. What is the meaning of indirect development? That whatever new offspring or progeny is formed, that progeny do not resemble to their parents because it is in the form of larva. After that, it will convert it into adult. The process of conversion of larva into adult is called as what? Metamorphosis. So development is indirect. Which larva is present in this phylum? Cedipid larva is present. The name of larva is cedipid. In sponges, the larva, name of that larva is Amphiblastula and Parenchymula. In Coelenterata, the name of larva is Planula. And here, in Ctenophora, the larva name is Cedipid larva. Examples include Pleurobrachia and Pleurobrachia and Ctenoplana. What is the scientific name of Pleurobrachia? Pleurobrachia is the scientific name. And what is the common name of this Pleurobrachia? C. gooseberries. And what is the common name for Ctenoplana? Comb jellies. Comb jellies. See, this is the Pleurobrachia and it is the 8 ciliated row. The rows which are present in 8 number and they are consisting what? Cilia. These help in what? Locomotion. And these are the 2 tentacles. These are the 2 tentacles which are arising from these Pleurobrachia organisms. See this. How they are emitting light. It is a pear-shaped organism. Some organism belong to tenophora are also cylindrical, some are pear shaped and some are spherical. So here you are seeing the organisms or example of these organisms. They shine or they emit the light. After this, next phylum is what? Platyhelminthes. What is the meaning of platyhelminth? Platy meaning flat and helminth means what? Helminth meaning worm. So the fourth phylum is platyhelminth. Platy meaning flat and helminth meaning worm-like organisms. The study of these worms is called as what? Helminthology. Study of helminths or worms is called as what? Helminthology. And members belong to these are called commonly called as what? Flatworms. Flat worm, because I told you during explanation of notochord that this is the dorsal surface, this is the ventral surface of the organism, if and in between cavity is present. As these platyhelminths are acoelomate, they don't have any cavity also in their body, because that cavity filled with the parenchymatous tissue. So this dorsal and ventral will look like flat as they don't contain any cavity in that. So that organisms are called as what? Flat worms, because no cavity. So they are called as what? Dorso-ventrally flattened. Their dorsal surface and ventral surface both look like fused. And that's why they are called as what? Dorso-ventrally flattened organisms, flat worms. Most of the organisms which come under this phylum are endoparasite. What is the meaning of endo? Endo meaning inside the body. They will live in the body of animals and even they are the parasite for humans also. In human body also, these helminths or worms will go and infect. So they are called as what? Endoparasites. Endo meaning living and parasite meaning causing harm to the organism. In which body they are living, to them only they will cause what? Harm. So they are endoparasites. Where they will live? In the body of organism as a parasite, and only few examples are there who are not infecting and they are living freely in the body of organisms. They are called as what? Flattened. They contain which type of body? Flattened body. Hence they are called as what? Flat worms. Mostly if you take these organisms are living inside the body. That's why they are called as what? Endoparasitic animals. These parasites will include humans also and another animals also. Like if you take sheep, they will infect to the sheep also and they will cause damage to the sheep body. Here, what is the level of organization? Level of organization. Now, as you move from lower phylum to higher phylum, you will see the level of organization is a bit improved or it was becoming somewhat complex. So before it was a tissue level. Before tissue level, there was a cellular level of organization in porifera. In coelenterate and tenophora, you have studied there is a tissue level of organization. In platyhelminths, there is organ organ level of organization is seen in these organisms. Meaning here, tissues again associate together to form organ, and this organ will do one particular function. So here again the complexity is bit increased as compared to tissue and cellular level of organization. After level of organization, digestive system, it is incomplete. Meaning still here also digestive system is incomplete, meaning what? They have only one opening in their alimentary canal. From this only food they have to take. So digestive pattern is incomplete in these organisms. Circulatory system is still absent here. After that, which type of symmetry is possessed by these organisms? From platyhelminths till chordates, you will have what type of symmetry? Bilateral, except what? Adult echinoderms. Except adult echinoderm, you will have all the bilateral symmetry which will begin from platyhelminths. So here, which type of symmetry is present? Bilateral symmetry. So what is the meaning of bilateral symmetry? The body of organism will be divided into two equal half by passing through only one plane. Only one plane can divide this organism to give equal pieces. If you pass another plane through their central axis, they will not give you equal pieces or equal parts. So that's why they are called as a bilateral symmetrical organism. They show which type of symmetry? Bilateral symmetry is present in these organism. Digestive pattern is incomplete. After symmetry, germ layers. How many germ layers are present here? They are triploblastic. From platyhelminth onward, you will have what? Triploblastic germ layer, meaning they have ectoderm, endoderm as well as mesoderm in their body. Triploblastic organisms. After germ layer, coelom. Is coelom present or absent in these organisms? Coelom is absent. That's why they are called as what? A coelomate. What is the meaning of a coelomate? Coelom is absent. So they have mesoderm. Then also why they are called as a coelomate? Because in their body, this is alimentary canal, and suppose it is a body, ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm is present, but they are present as a cell. As they don't have any body cavity, if body cavity is not there, how that cavity can be lined by the mesoderm? This all, it is filled with the parenchyma matrix or loose mesoderm cell. So they have only alimentary canal, which is incomplete, and remaining all their body is filled with the tissue. That's why they are called as what? A coelomate organisms. And that's why if body cavity is not present, then they will look as flat organisms. That's why they are called as what? Flat worms. In these organisms also notochord is absent. That's why they are considered under they are considered in non-chordates. And they show what? False segmentation. Example for false segmentation is tapeworm. Tapeworm show what? Pseudo metameric segments. Tapeworm show pseudo pseudometameric segmentation. Digestion, how that food is coming to their body surface, as they are endoparasite, they are living in the host body. So whatever their cell body surface is there, from that body surface, they are present in intestine of the human. So in the intestine, already digested food or partially digested food will be there. It will just absorb that digested food from their body surface, or sometime from their external aperture also they will absorb food. And as I told, these are endoparasite. These endoparasite meaning they are living in the intestine. This intestine may contain mucous membrane. So that mucous membrane will be slippery. So these organisms develop what? Hooks and suckers. Hooks and suckers are present. As they are parasite, they need protection and they have to penetrate here, and they need some supportive structure. So that supportive structures are nothing but hooks and suckers. So these are the segmentation, and I told they show pseudometamerism. So I am giving the example of tapeworm. See, the new segments are joined from, added from anterior surface, and as you go to the posterior region, it has already developed or before formed segments, and it is attached to our intestinal wall. And here suckers are present. What is the meaning of sucker? They will attach to the intestine with the help of sucker and hooks. Along with that, this sucker is helping this organism to get all the nutrition absorbed in their body, and full body surface is able to take all the digested food material inside their body. And as these organisms are living in the body to get protection from the intestinal enzymes, this organism contain outer slimy layer also, tunic it is called as. After digestion, they show anaerobic respiration, meaning during aerobic respiration, we use oxygen to break the food and we will get energy. But here during anaerobic respiration, they will break the food, but energy released is in less amount. As they are living in inside the body of organism, their oxygen, they will not need depend completely on the oxygen. So respiration is by respiration is of a anaerobic respiration they show. Now they have some excretory structure that is called as what? Phlegm cell. A specialized cell is present for excretion. That cell is called as what? Excretory cell is called as what? Phlegm cell. Why it is called as phlegm cell? Because this is the phlegm cell. It is like bit protruding. It also contains nucleus, as it is a modification of normal cell only. And they contain cilia inside. So whenever these cilia beat or move, it will do look like a flickering of the fire. Whenever these move, cilias will move, it will show flickering like. That's why they are called as what? Phlegm cells. and from here they will collect what? Ammonia. In this organism also ammonia is excretory waste, so they will collect this ammonia and they will pass that ammonia from this excretory tube. From this that ammonia is released outside of their body. So these are called as what? Flame cell. A specialized excretory cells are present in these platyhelminths. Cilia like structure, and here they will collect ammonia. That flame cells are also called as solenocytes. That is the type of excretion, and ammonia is needed to excrete the waste. Ammonia is the excretory waste and they are releasing with the help of those flame cells. After that, you will come to know that the new term they have given, that is called as what? Osmoregulation. Meaning these organisms will show osmoregulation. So what is the meaning of osmoregulation? So you know solvent. This is, suppose it is a water and contain more number of salts. So if the concentration of salt is more, that solution, meaning we will call that in this solvent, solutes are more. Suppose I will give you one example. In one normal body, 282, 300 milli osmol per liter. If those osmolites or solute particles should be present, how much? I am giving a general example that osmol per liter. The concentration of solute per liter of the solvent is called as what? Osmolarity. Suppose in one organism 300 milliosmol concentration of solute should be there. But what happens if more than 300, that concentration will increase more than 300. If it become 400, then also that organism may face problem. And if the concentration becomes less than the normal, then also it will become problematic. So how much osmolarity should be maintained in our body? 300. But if it is increased, suppose in surrounding water or surrounding body more salts are present or more osmolites are present, in such case this organism body needs only 300, but that osmolite increased to 400, then extra amount of osmolite should be excreted out. And here if less is there, meaning again somehow that osmolite concentration should come to the normal. So who is maintaining this osmoregulation? That flame cell will help in the osmoregulation of these organism. Here excretion, I told, it is from the flame cell. After that, how these organisms reproduce? Reproduction. These organisms are hermaphrodite. That is, both the sexes are present in the same organism. Meaning, these organisms are bisexual. These organisms are what? Bisexual. And fertilization takes place as? Fertilization is internal. As these organisms are living in the intestine or in the body of other organisms, both the sexes they contain in one organism only. Internal meaning if they release their fertilized egg, or if external fertilization occur, that egg due to the enzyme activity it may get damaged. So that's why that fertilization occur inside the body of the organism only. That is called as what? Fertilization is internal. Sexes are, both the sexes are present in same organism. and development, how it, development takes place. Development is indirect and it show many larval stages are present. Many larval stages like metasarcaria, sarcaria, those larval stage are many. After that larval stage, this organism will convert it into adult one. Example, you can take liver fluke, Fasciola hepatica. It will infect the sheeps. After that, Tenia solium. Tenia solium means pork worm, it is called as. Its normal name is tapeworm. And liver fluke, common name we will study. Fasciola hepatica, liver fluke, and Tenia solium, it is called as what? Tapeworm. Fasciola hepatica, full name of liver fluke. In these organisms, I told nervous that nerve cells are developed from tenophora. In these organisms also, nerves are developed. Suppose this is the body of that organism and they contain two nerve cord. Nerve cord are double. Don't confuse these nerve cord with the notochord. Notochord will give, it is a skeletal part. But this is a neural part. And nerve is ladder-like. In these organisms, these nerves are arranged in the form of ladder. It will look like ladder when we see from outside. That's why they are called as nervous system is like ladder. Ladder-like nervous system. Here those cell body, dendrites, these two are called as what? One, this and this and this. It is made up of nerves, but notochord, it was a skeletal structure. So that nerves are present as ladder, arranged like ladder. So it will run throughout their body like this, and here it will end. So, the nervous system is like a ladder. See, this is the head of this tapeworm. It has suckers to suck the food, digested food from the intestine. It is the enlarged head of these tapeworms. So these are the false segments. The mature segment or mature compartment is called as what? Proglottid. The mature segment contain egg of these tapeworms. So proglottid, it is a mature segment in the tapeworms. After that, this is the liver fluke. Here you will see the mouth surrounded by suckers, and here also it is a ventral sucker. It is called as what? Ventral sucker or acetabulum. It will help that organism to get attached in the host body. What is the meaning of host? Where this organism is going to live, that person's body is called as what? Host. And they are considered as parasite to that host. And living inside the body, that's why they are called as what? Endoparasite. And these organisms are living and infecting animals, mean they should have some protective structures around their body so that they should get protection from our enzymes and mucus layers. So the mature segment is called as what? Proglottid, I told. Example which belong to this platyhelminth is called as what? Tenia solium. And another example they have given what? Fasciola hepatica, liver fluke. What we have studied in today's class? In today's class, we have studied about Ctenophora. These Ctenophora, what are the special characters present in only Ctenophora? The 8 comb, which contains cilia, that structure, light emitting property. These are exclusively marine. No one example is present in the freshwater. Apart from that, they contain how many tentacles? 2 tentacles. They bear 8 rows of ciliated comb plates, which will help these organisms to do locomotion or move freely in the water surface. And we studied that in this phylum, only fertilization is sexual. Development is indirect. Contain larva. That larva name is what? Cedipid larva. And these organisms possess a character or feature of light emission. The light which is emitted by living organism is called, that property is called as what? Bioluminescence. Example, we have studied that Pleurobrachia and Ctenoplana. Pleurobrachia's common name sea gooseberry and Ctenoplana's common name is comb jellies. After that, we have studied next phylum, that is platyhelminths. We know that helminth meaning what? Study helminth mean worm. And study of helminth is called as what? Helminthology. These organisms cause infection or parasitic infection to the human. That's why they are called as what? Infectious or parasitic organism, usually present in the body of animals and even in the body of humans. These animals will come and infect. After that, we have studied its specialized organ, that is hooks and suckers. These suckers are helping these organisms to suck the nutrition from the intestine or in the body. Wherever they will get nutrition, they have to suck that nutrition, already digested food material from the organism. They have suckers. And to get attached with the host body, they need hooks. So here hooks and suckers are present. First time organ developed in these organisms. Flame cell was the excretory structure or cell which was helping these organisms to collect all the ammonia and excrete with the help of excretory tube. After that, we have studied what? Examples and how reproduction is occurring. Reproduction occurs inside the body. Is any male and female sexual dimorphism is present? No. They don't have any type of sexual dimorphism, meaning they contain both male and female structure in the same organism. In the same organism, both male and female structure or gametes are present. Fertilization will occur inside. After that, they are present in intestine and they will release egg from the intestine out with the help of fecal matter. Along with fecal matter, there these mature proglottids, I told, na, this each one segment containing fertilized egg, it will be released outside with the fecal matter. And when this fecal matter eaten by the pig, then again in the pig it will infect, certain larval stages will develop in pig body, and again there who eats that pig or pork, uncooked, not properly cooked pig, again that larval stage will infect in humans and it will live in the intestine. This organism, specially tapeworm, infect the intestine of the humans. That's why they are called as what? Endoparasite. Respiration is anaerobic type. Sucker is helping this organism to suck the food. Apart from that, it will help to attach also. Bit kind of attachments. So these two phylums we have studied today. After that, we will revise bit from previous phylum, Porifera, cellular grade of organization. These were the example, Spongula, Eusporia and Cycon. You have to remember its common name also. Spongula is called as what? Freshwater sponge. Cycon is called as what? Scypha. That common scientific name and common name I have given here. So these are the important, Cycon, Scypha. Spongula, freshwater sponge, and Eusporia, bath sponge. After that, we have studied that they contain coelenterata. This coelenterate contain a central cavity. It is called as what? Coelenteron, or it is also called as what? Gastrovascular cavity, because here the cells which are present, they will secrete certain enzymes and digest food incompletely. And after that, remaining incomplete digested food will enter in the cell and remaining further digestion will be completed within the cell. That's why here digestion is both extracellular as well as intracellular. They contain a specialized cell called nidoblast cell. These nidoblast contain a subcellular part. A subcellular part of this nidoblast is called as what? Nematocyst. This nematocyst contain refractile rods and supporting fibrils. Whenever organism is coming to attack these coelenterates, it will throw these refractile or supporting fiber and refractile rod on their body. So those organisms will get damaged. After that, we have studied the location of that nematocyst, this nidoblast cell. See, they have enlarged this portion. And they have shown where nidoblast cells are present. And when enemy is not there around them or food particle is not around them, this all the tube, thread tube will go inside. And when enemy or prey, meaning what? Food. These organism eat food. When food of these organism come near, that is prey will come near these organism, they will infect that or they will attach that organism or pierce that organism, or you can call it as they will give stinging thread. They will keep stinging thread in that organism and release certain chemicals in the body of that prey so that this prey will get paralyzed. So about nidocyst, we have studied nidocyte. After that, we have studied in the coelenterata, there are two forms, polyp as well as medusa. Medusa is umbrella-like structure and polyp is a cylindrical structure, non-motile structure, and this is motile structure. See here, another difference is it is their opening and it is the cavity, and these are the tentacles of these coelenterates. These coelenterates in medusa form or motile form of coelenterates have their mouth or one external opening down, facing downwards along with the tentacles. Tentacle as well as this opening is facing downwards and looking like umbrella. So these medusa form look like umbrella shape and polyp look like cylindrical shape. And in the polyp, only one opening is there situated on the elevated region that is called as hypostome. And in these hypostome and mouth or one single opening, which is that it is facing upward along with the tentacles. These tentacles and the one single opening is facing upward, but in medusa form that is coming downside. And we have studied a specialized structure or cavity in these coelenterate, that's cavity is called as what? Created layer. This is called as what? Mesoglia for structural support. And we have studied this also, that way how these nidoblast cells are situated on the ectoderm, and whenever prey will come around this, this ectoderm will release that thread tube and paralyze that organism. We have studied about interstitial cells also yesterday. These are the totipotent cell which will help these organism to grow the last part. If suppose this tentacle is affected or cutted, somehow those tentacles will again regrow. That is called as what? With the help of interstitial cell. We have studied these examples also. For platyhelmin, they have given planaria. It contains high regeneration capacity. Meaning, if some lost parts of this organism become lost, that lost part will be regenerated or regrown again. And their gastrovascular cavity is branched. They have branched the gastrovascular cavity. And here they have mouth or opening. That opening is this side. So this was about the platyhelmins. So after that, we will study next phylum in next class. So thank you for watching.